Thank you. virgin full of grace, by the Holy Ghost conceiving, bear the Savior of our race, and the babe, the world's Redeemer, first revealed his sacred face, evermore and evermore. Of the Father's love begotten, ere the worlds began to be, he is Alpha and Omega, he the source, the end in he. All the things that are that have been and the future you shall see, evermore and evermore.
Thank you. Thank you. assembly is invited to sing this song. Please stand.
Good afternoon and Merry Christmas, everyone. Sorry, a little bit of awkward greeting that way. Welcome, everybody, and I just want to focus our attention as we've been listening to some wonderful music today, and we get our hearts and minds focused for what we're about to be celebrating in just a couple weeks. We look at what God's Word says to us. If you looked at the front of your service folder, it says rejoice. As we've gathered around this school year, that's been the theme for our school year, to rejoice in the Lord always. And we look at our lives, and God has certainly given us many reasons to rejoice. We see what He has done for us and blessed us in a variety of ways, but as we focus our attention to the coming of our King this Christmas season, well, that's one more reason to rejoice, isn't it? As we look at the words that are printed there, that first verse, it says, rejoice greatly, daughter Zion, shout, daughter Jerusalem, see your king comes to you righteous and victorious. Doesn't really look that way all the time, though, does it? You look at what's going on around the world, and sometimes we wonder, where is God in all of this? You continue to look, and it says, He will proclaim peace to the nations. Seems like there's not a whole lot of peace to go around, is there? You turn on the news, and you look at what's going on in Europe. You turn on the news, and look at what's going on in the Middle East. You turn on the news, and look at what's going on in our own country, in our own state. And it doesn't seem like there's a whole lot of peace to be had. And a lot of times, at this time of year, people talk about peace on earth, because that's what the angels claimed That's what they proclaimed on the hills outside of Bethlehem. But do you ever wonder, God, where is that peace? I don't seem to be seeing it anywhere. God, have you forgotten your promise? God, have you forgotten your declaration? You see your king comes, righteous and victorious. Yeah, we can freely proclaim that God is righteous, but do you ever wonder, is God really victorious? Because so often it seems like that message of the gospel is being silenced. We don't see necessarily churches thriving, and you wonder, God, are you really victorious? Or you take yourself back 2,000 years. Did it really look like God was righteous and victorious in the town of Bethlehem? You'd imagine if he's righteous and victorious, everyone's going to come out to see him and celebrate him, but it was just shepherds that came to visit him. It wasn't kings that knelt before him, but hidden in a stable. But yet, why do we remember that day that took place so long ago? Why are we gathered here today to sing these songs of praise to God, to listen to this music that is proclaiming God's message? Because we know our Lord is victorious. The reason we celebrate, the reason we give thanks to God today and every day is the gift that he was giving in Bethlehem. It wasn't that God was just keeping a promise he had made. But God himself was coming to this world out of his love for you. You see, we look around and we see it's the unrest in our world. We see the peacelessness that is all around us, and sometimes we begin to doubt God. Sometimes we begin to question God's power, his love, his victory. But that's one of the many reasons that Christ was sent to that town of Bethlehem. To fulfill those promises that God had made all the way back in the Garden of Eden, and he had reiterated throughout the pages of the Old Testament, promising a Savior for them and a Savior for us, a Savior for all mankind. And while it didn't look like it was a grand event, it didn't look like he came in righteousness and victory in Bethlehem, we certainly know what would later take place. We see how Jesus conquered death, winning that ultimate victory, not as something that he needed to do for himself, but he needed to do it for us. And he has done it for us. And now as we get ready to celebrate the coming of our Savior, we not only celebrate the first coming that he had when he took on flesh to take our sins away, but we celebrate that coming again when, yes, Jesus will be all victorious. When we will see Jesus coming on those clouds of heaven, when we will see Jesus proclaiming his victory to all those doubts, they're gone. They're eliminated. They're replaced with joy, replaced with hope. And yes, we see our King coming victorious, coming righteous. And the peace that he promises, it's not that peace that we're going to find here on earth, but it's the peace that he has proclaimed, the peace that stands between God and us, the peace that says we need not fear, but we can rejoice in our coming King. Once again, the words from Zechariah chapter 9. Rejoice greatly, daughter Zion. Shout, daughter Jerusalem. See, your King comes to you, righteous and victorious. He will proclaim peace to the nations. His rule will extend from sea to sea and from the river to the ends of the earth. This is the word of the Lord. At this time, we'll gather our offerings. If you would like to give digitally or electronically, there is a QR code in the service folder.
Son to save us. The love is blooming from us. Alleluia, alleluia, from the branch of Jesse grows. Alleluia. To save us.
praising. Loudly sing his love amazing. Worthy folk of Christendom.
Invite the assembly to join in on this next Christmas hymn. The words are in your service folder.
Oh,
rest, ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day, to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. From God our heavenly brother a blessed angel came, and unto certain shepherds brought tidings of the same. And as in Bethlehem was born the Son of God by name. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. Fear not, said the angel, let nothing you affret. This day is born a Savior, a virgin pure and bright, to free all those who trust in him from Satan's power and might. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. Now to the Lord sing praises, all you within this place, and with true love and charity each other now embrace. This holy tide of Christmas is filled with heavenly grace. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
Thank you all for joining us here this afternoon for our Christmas concert. If we could kindly have everybody that was involved in the concert today please stand. So thank you all very much, and let's praise God by showing our appreciation to the gifts that they used. Great job, kids. You can sit back down, thanks. We would also like to express our gratitude to our two directors, Pastor Schrader and Mr. Rosenbaum. Thank you, men. Mr. Dearson and Pastor Schrader were on the sound and also live streaming today, so thank you. There are refreshments available in the cafeteria afterwards, which would be right up this through this door right here and up the ramp. So please stick around a little bit and enjoy some cookies and refreshment as we celebrate this time of Christmas. And just generally speaking, to the parents that we are fortunate enough to be able to partner with to serve your students for their high school years. We greatly appreciate that so much, and thank you for giving us a chance to serve you and your family in this wonderful Christ-centered atmosphere here at California Lutheran High School. To those of you that support us, we greatly appreciate all of your continued prayers for our ministry as we are in our 48th year of existence here at CalLU. And at this time of the year, many of you are looking and considering where you might be able to support ministries and charities and organizations that are near and dear to your heart. We would greatly appreciate you considering how you might be able to support what's happening here at California Lutheran High School. To that end, a couple of families that do keep this place near and dear to their hearts have provided us the opportunity to present a matching gift here in the month of December. $70,000 is going to be matched. For every dollar that you would give, it will come back as two to our high school. And so if you have the ability to support us with your with a financial gift along with all the other support that you give us. It would go to a great cause and be put to great use. And once again, for every dollar that you would give, it would be matched and doubled. So as you're considering your end of the year and your Christmas gifts, please keep California Lutheran High School in that consideration for all of you. We wish you all a very blessed Christmas as we continue to take a look and get excited for what's going to happen in Bethlehem on December 25th. Our students have 1 week of regular school and then a week of exams. So they are looking forward to these last 2 weeks of their first semester. And we wish you all a very Merry Christmas. God bless you all. Thank you.